College was burnt, says the prefect of Hall's book, November the 10th, 1815, at 3 o'clock in the morning. The fire broke out over first and second chambers in Chamber Court at Winchester. The roof and furniture was destroyed, but the chief feature of the occasion was the enthusiasm of the townsfolk who helped to extinguish it. I am indebted to Miss Foster from the archives at Winchester College for her help in finding and deciphering some of the many documents that survive from this period. One of the more exciting documents from the period is a letter. The archives still possess a typed copy of the letter. My dearest George, I received your letter last Thursday, which I assure you I thought you very good for writing so soon after your arrival, as I suppose you must have been in a grand bustle. What a terrible fire it must have been at college. Miss Huntingford wrote Emily a long account of it. Mr. Clark has lost about £600. I believe that it is supposed to have begun in his rooms. The alterations were just finished, and there were fires in all the rooms to air them. Mr. Clark was to have slept there that night for the first time, but was prevented, having had a dinner party for the last time in his lodgings. It is a very unpleasant circumstance, and I should suppose that Mr. Clark would feel it very much. He is in a delicate state of health, and so very nervous. Most fortunately, no lives were lost, and I believe no one was in the least hurt, which I think surprising. The fire broke out at 3 o'clock in the morning, when it must have been perfectly dark. It was some time before any engine could be got that was of the least use. Some of them could not get in at the college gate. Another had no pipes long enough. At last, the soldiers brought one from the barracks, which had pipes long enough to reach over the Thames. What a shocking scene of confusion there must have been. Also possessed by the college are their accounting books and receipts. The bursar or moneykeeper of Winchester College kept a very detailed log of all payments which the college made. On the left you can see a receipt from the time of the fire, and on the right you can see one of the accounting books. In the left-hand column of the accounting books is the date of the payment. In the image which you can see, there is no date as it is a continuation from a previous page. In the middle column, there is a description of the payment, and in the right-hand columns are the amounts of the payments, in pre-decimal notation. In the left-hand column of this right-hand block is pounds, denoted by a pound symbol at the top of the page. In the middle column is shillings, denoted by an S. And in the far-right column is pennies, denoted by a D, curiously. This originates from the Roman denarius. We will explore these documents throughout this video. Here is an extract from the accounts. The bottom entry's description is as follows. Remuneration to persons who assisted at the college fire, November the 10th, 1815. The payment is of £51 exactly. This is approximately £5,000 in today's money. There is a book which lists all of the individual people to whom the college gave money after the fire. Here is an extract from that book. On the left is the opening page, and on the right is a random page of people who received money. No fewer than 257 people received small sums on this occasion. Later in the book, it mentions that some people's remunerations in part consisted of a beer down at the local pub. The great difficulty in working out who was owed money was also mentioned later on in the book. This was important, so that the college did not remunerate anyone who didn't help, saving their funds and maintaining a reason for people to help in the future. This is a receipt from before the fire broke out. The relevant entry on it says, July 1815, examining engine pipes and buckets. 7 shillings. The college had bought a fire engine after a previous fire, which we will discuss in a future video. It's perhaps lucky that they had bought the fire engine and had examined these pipes and buckets before the fire broke out, otherwise far greater damage could have been done. Chamber Court has stayed very similar to how William of Wickham would have left it because of this. Here are the last two extracts from the archives which were particularly relevant. On the right is an extract from the accounts just after the fire. About halfway down the page, we can see the relevant entries. DO, which I assume means dole, for lead work, pumps, etc., in the new building on the east side of the quadrangle. £409, 5 shillings and 1 and 3 quarter pence. Dole for 135 foot of pipe to the engine and repairing dole. £40, 19 shillings and 6 pence. Dole for work in the new building. £117, 9 shillings and 1 pence. White for leather from repairing engine and bucket. £3, 17 shillings and 6 pence. And so on. Just on this page, there were approximately £4,000 worth of spending due to the fire, which in today's money is equivalent to £350,000. The damage caused cannot have been as minor as we first thought. At the bottom of the left-hand extract reads an entry as follows. To Godwin, for putting up bedsteads at sick house and in rooms over Mr. Williams' lodgings for the boys of first and second chambers. This is a photograph of the interior of first chamber today. It looks very different to how it would have done before the fire. However, this photo of the exterior of first and second chambers would look fairly similar to how the exterior would have looked before the fire. I hope that you have enjoyed listening to and looking at some of the documents which helped to describe the fire on the 10th of November in 1815. If you enjoyed this, then I would recommend that you check out my website, godtress.wixsite.com/cornucopia, which contains similar content. Thank you for watching.